In this clip, we're going to be using a combination of photos and topographic maps to study coastal processes, the geologic processes that shape our coastlines. We can think about coastlines in terms of sea level change. Is the coastline uplifting, in which case we have relative sea level fall, land surface rising out of the sea? We would call that an emergent coastline. Or is the coastline in an area where sea level is rising relative to the land surface, either because the land surface is sinking or global sea levels are rising, in which case we would have a coastline that we would say to be submergent, sea level rise. Emergent would be local or relative sea level fall. Now, this is Cape Blanco, southwest Oregon. Here, we're relatively close to the convergent plate boundary, the subduction zone that's offshore. This is the part of the Oregon coast that comes closest to the offshore subduction zone or trench. As a result, there's lots of compression along this coastline, and we have a coastline that's being actively uplifted by plate tectonic processes. In other words, the land surface is rising, making sea level appear to be falling at this location. This is another image of Cape Blanco. Here we're looking at the very tip of Cape Blanco and viewing it from the south, looking towards the north. The thing to note here in this image is that we have this flat surface out on the tip of Cape Blanco. That's a marine terrace. In other words, an area that had been leveled by wave action, but has actually risen well above the current local sea level. We call those, again, marine terraces, and they occur on coastlines that are emergent, coastlines that are being uplifted, producing a local sea level fall. This is the topographic map for Cape Blanco. Previous photo was taken from the south, looking north at Cape Blanco. What would terraces look like on a topographic map? In other words, terraces occur where you have a stair step appearance to the land surface. On a map, that would be reflected by having closely spaced contours on the risers of the stairs, and then contours that are farther apart on the flat or step part of the stairs. Here we see a bunch of closely spaced contours here. Those are our risers, areas where we have relatively fast elevation change. And then we see these flat surfaces with widely spaced contours. That's the step of our staircase. So in looking for or identifying marine terraces on a map, you would look for an area of closely spaced contours indicating an abrupt vertical change, separated by an area with widely spaced contours. Steeper, where the contours are closely spaced, flatter, where they're wider apart, and then maybe you would see another set of closely spaced contours as we step up another of these marine terraces. This photo shows Siletz Bay, which is just north of Newport, just south of Lincoln City on the central Oregon coast. Much farther north than Cape Blanco. Cape Blanco is relatively close to the offshore subduction zone, convergent or compressional forces resulting in uplift. The coastline is also being uplifted here, but a much slower rate. Sea level is actually rising faster. Sea level has risen faster since the end of the Ice Age because of the melting of large glaciers and ice sheets worldwide, adding water to the ocean. That's resulted in the river mouths being drowned by relatively high sea level, forming these bays or estuaries. Where you see rivers ending in large bays or estuaries, it's a good indicator that you're on a submergent coastline, an area of net sea level rise. in a submergent coastline, sediment movement generated by coastal currents, specifically the longshore drift, become an important mechanism to shape the coastline. The river is delivering sand to the ocean. Wave action is moving that sand up and down the beach, generating what we call a longshore current or longshore sediment drift, where you see a bar or spit across the mouth of that bay, you're getting an indication of what direction the longshore current is moving. Here's the bay mouth here. Then we see this spit that extends across much of the length of Siletz Bay. That spit is being extended from south to north. In other words, it's attached to the coastline at the south end, open at its north end. That's a good indicator that the longshore current is moving sediment from south to north. In other words, the spit is being extended in this direction over time. This is the topographic map for Siletz Bay. Previous picture was taken from the east, looking west towards the ocean. We see the submerged river mouth, indicating there's been net sea level rise at this location. We have a submergent coastline, and we see a long spit across the mouth of the bay. That spit is being built by sand delivered to the ocean by the river, and then reworked, redistributed by the longshore current, a coastal ocean current generated by wave action. Notice that the spit is attached to the coastline at the south end, yet open at its north end. In other words, the spit is being extended in this direction, from south to north. And that tells us the longshore current is also moving from south to north. If it was moving in the opposite direction, what would the spit look like? The spit would be being built or extended from north to south over time if the longshore current was moving in the opposite direction, north to south. This image shows Cohasset Beach on the coast of Washington near the mouth of Gray's Harbor. Notice this wedge of sand that is accumulating against the jetty on the south entrance to Gray's Harbor. The jetty is constructed to keep the mouth of the harbor open. In other words, to keep it from being filled in by sand being moved along the shoreline by the longshore current. Because the sand wedge is getting wider in this direction, that reflects the accumulation of sediment in a longshore current that's moving from south to north. Same direction as we saw in the example of the spit at the mouth of Siletz Bay. That sand is being blocked from moving any farther north by the jetty that's been constructed at the mouth of Gray's Harbor. Sand is accumulating against the south side of that jetty because that sand is moving from south to north in the longshore current.